Unit 3, VHF, UHF and microwave antenna prepared by Dr. Srinivasulu. Just a reflector, what is the reflector antennas? Most important in microwave radiation applications. So at microwave frequency, size of antenna small. Frequency and size are inversely proportional. Any shape of reflector produces desired directivity. Next, in reflector antenna, another antenna need to excite it. Dipole, horn, antenna, slot. Used for excite, so-called primary antenna. Reflector antenna also called as secondary antenna. Reflector represent any shape. Most common geometrics are plane, corner, curved or parabolic reflectors. Flat sheet reflector or plane reflector. It is the simplest form of reflector antenna. Is kept in front of the field. So the flat sheet energy is radiated in the desired direction. To increase the directivity, the large flat sheet placed in front of the off a dipole antenna. The main advantage is to reduce backward radiation and increase gain in forward direction. So here different diagrams are there. Diagram number A, plane reflector. It consisting of fader lights and reflector. Next in figure B, half a dipole with plane reflectors. Figure C, half a dipole array with plane reflectors. Figure D, half a dipole with reflector element. So different reflectors are shown in this diagram. So what is the corner reflector? What are the main disadvantages of corner reflector? Disadvantage of flat reflector is back and side radiation. So that will be modified in a corner reflector. However, join two flat reflector with some angle, concentrate radiation in forward direction. It is called the corner reflector. So the angle is also called include angle. Angle is 90 degrees. Sometimes angle other than 90 degrees used. So here diagram A, corner reflector top view. So this is the corner reflector top view. Next diagram, corner reflector front view. The front corner reflector front view consists of fader element and dipole antenna, some alpha is angle. So next one. So here there are two types of corner reflectors. First one, active corner reflector, sometimes it is also called with the source. So another one, passive corner reflector without source, with the source and without source. So this is the vertical corner reflector with the field pattern along main axis. In this diagram, so here lambda of a dipole antenna. So here transmission line, here transmission line, here transmission line. So here alpha is 90 degrees, F is flat sheet, D is a driving element, alpha corner angle. So this is the field pattern. So here main axis, this dotted line is called the main axis. Next one. So this is another diagram, passive corner reflector without any driving element. So in the diagram, we are not using the driving element. Only we are in the half a dipole antenna. So theta I, incident wave. So the theta R, incident wave and reflected wave. So here. Next one. So method of images for square corner reflector. Consider a square corner reflector with a corner angle alpha is 90 degrees. This reflector consists one driving element represented by D, which is located at point and shown by 1. So in this diagram, so one point is there, that is the driving element. Corresponding to one driving element, three images represented by 2, 2, 3, 4 are as shown in this diagram. The driving element along with all three images carry current of same magnitude, but currents in a driving antenna and its image, number two, image two, are in phase, while the currents in the image elements three and four are out of phase by 180 degrees. Next one, the electric field in horizontal plane at a distance r from the antenna is given by E phi of theta is equal to k dash I1 of cos alpha d cos theta minus cos of alpha d sine theta. So here alpha is the angle, d is the distance of that one, k is a constant, where I1 is a current in each element, k is a constant corresponding distance, or d is the distance of driving element from the corner along the main axis. The terminal voltage at the center of driving element is given by V1 is equal to I1 plus Z11 plus I1 Z12 minus Z1 Z13 minus I1 Z14, where Z1 is a self impedance of driving element, which is lambda by 2 dipole, that is 73 ohms, that is a impedance. Z12, mutual impedance between the elements 1 and 2. Z13 equal to Z14, that is the mutual impedance between elements 1 and 3, elements 1 and 4. So here V1 is equal to Z1 plus Z12 minus 2 Z14 into I1. Next, if P is a power supplied to the driving element, the power input to each image also remains same. That is a P. Now, power can be expressed in terms of current I1 as P is equal to I1 square into R. So, therefore, I1 is equal to under root P by R. So I1 is equal to under root P by R11 plus R12 minus 2R14. Equation 3 is written by considering resistive part of all the impedance, putting expression of I1 in equation number 1. So previous slides, we get, so E phi of theta equal to K dash root of P by R11 plus R12 minus 2R14 into cos of alpha d cos theta minus cos of alpha d sine theta. That is equation number 4. If reflector is removed, what will happen in this diagram? Then no image element can exist. Thus, R1 equal to R14, that is equal to 0. So then only half a dipole as a driving element remains. The electric field due to isolated lambda root dipole antenna is given by, therefore, E pi of theta lambda by 2 equal to k dash root of P by R11. Now gain in the theta direction is obtained by dividing equation 1 by 5. We get finally g of theta equal to e pi of theta divided by e pi of theta lambda, that is equal to root of R11 by R11 plus R12 minus 2R14 into cos of alpha d cos theta minus cos of alpha d sine theta. So in this diagram, so 1 and 2 and 3, 4 different elements are mentioned. Here, R under root R11 divided by R11 plus R12 minus 2R14 is called coupling factor, while the term cos of alpha d cos theta minus cos of alpha d sine theta is called the pattern factor. From the equation 6, it is clear that the field pattern depends on angle theta and spacing d. The field pattern consists of four loops. Out of these four loops, only one is real, while others are its images as shown in this diagram. But we know that for corner reflector, the maximum radiation is in the direction theta is equal to 0 degrees. Hence, putting theta is equal to 0 in equation number 6, we get, therefore, G naught equal to G theta equal to 0. That is equal to under root R11 divided R11 plus R12 minus 2R14 into cos of BD beta D minus 1. So design of equation for corner reflector. The important dimension in the corner reflector are as follows. Da is the dimension of aperture. D equal to distance between the feed lines and the vertex of the reflector. L is the side length of the reflector shade. It is in general practice, the side length L is selected equal to twice the distance D. Lens design equation are given as follows. D equal to L by 2 or L is equal to 2D. Now Da equal to root of L square plus L square, that is equal to root of 2L square. So that is root of root 2 into L, that is equal to 1.414 into L. Root 2 is a 1.414. But L is equal to 2D. What will happen? Therefore, Da equal to 1.414 into 2D. That is equal to 2.828 into D. Thus, Da equal to 1.414, L equal to 2.828 D. Equation 1 and 4 are called design equations of corner reflector. Thank you.